5 years ago, Italy stood poised to invade Ethiopia under the leadership of a would-be Caesar, Benito Mussolini. It takes on fresh historical significance today. Il Duce's intentions were clear, and in Geneva, the League of Nations met to consider the plight of the small African kingdom, then one of only two independent nations on the Dark Continent. To the spokesman of the member nations, the threat was grave, not only to Ethiopian freedom, but to the very peace of the world. The statesmen who dominated the international scene in the 30s were confronted with a challenge to conscience. The League voted economic sanctions against Italy in response to Ethiopia's pleas, but the League was relatively ineffectual, and its sanctions were scorned by Mussolini. Many of the figures in the news then, such as Pierre Laval of France, later a collaborator, and Boncour of France, figure prominently in a generation's history of tragic futility against the mounting threat of totalitarian aggression. Faced with the threat of League boycott, Mussolini nonetheless massed his legions and, without even a declaration of war, rolled across the Ethiopian frontier into the mountain fastnesses of Haile Selassie's kingdom. The most highly mobilized war machine of the day was on the move. Against the attack, only high-spirited but poorly armed and disorganized tribal forces could be mustered by Haile Selassie. A gallant but foredoomed struggle was in the offing. Today, a quarter of a century later, the hopes of the world for peace lie in the successor to the League, the United Nations, faced with the problems of new nations like the Congo that offer tempting prey for communist aggression, more skillful and subtle by far than Mussolini. One of history's tragedies of the 30s is vivid in memory. Whether to be repeated on even greater scale or to be avoided is a question still in the balance.